हाँ, सो वॉट वे वी डूइंग, हाँ वी वर डूइंग लॉ ऑफ डॉट्स, सो वी वर डूइंग लॉ ऑफ डॉट्स, करेक्ट? ओके, सो वी स्टार्टेड विद लॉ ऑफ डॉट्स. वॉट इज लॉ ऑफ डॉट्स? टॉट मीन्स वॉट? टॉट मीन्स सिविल रॉन्ग. यस, ओके सर. हाँ, सो लॉ ऑफ डॉट्स वॉज अ अनकोडिफाइड लॉ, दैट इज देर इज नो लेजिस्लेशन, इट इज जस्ट दैट द प्रेसिडेंस, द नंबर ऑफ केस लॉज, certain theories given by certain experts, everything together, there it has become a law called law of torts. Yes, if that is what we had discussed. So what is tort, sir? Tort means wrong. But what will we be studying? Tort here, which we will be studying, will be civil wrong. So what do you mean by civil wrong? Civil wrong is basically any person who is infringing, basically he is causing any harm towards your legal rights given by your government. Basically, whatever your personal rights are, your private rights are, if someone is causing a damage to that, then you can any day file a case in a civil court under, that is what we'll be seeing under law of torts. That was, and if you remember, we did civil wrong versus criminal wrong, public law. If at all something of this sort happened, the public will lose the interest on, they will lose the confidence on the police or government. That is the reason under criminal law, the what do you say, the state, that is the government, fights your case, whereas in civil law you will only fight your case. We saw certain differences, murder and all that. Here it was defamation, civil wrongs basically. Contract also we saw, breach of contract. But yes, breach of contract we will not be seeing under law of tort, but still it was considered as a civil wrong. So we said all civil wrongs need not be breach of tort, but all torts are civil wrongs. That is what was the conclusion. Yes. And just one more thing to that point only. Whenever law of torts, now say for example under criminal law, yeah, say CRPC, or say under Indian Penal Code, IPC, or you take any section, yeah, whenever there is a law, whenever you do not comply with that particular law, in that section only the govern, I mean in that section only Act tells you what is going to be the penalty. Now say for example if you do something wrong as per criminal law, yeah, kidnap or something, the law has already given you what will be the penalty, whether you will be filing, I mean you will be arrested for how long, if you have to pay penalty, how much. In any law, the moment you say it is an act, in that act how much penalty will already be prescribed. But under torts it is always called as unliquidated damages. Yeah, under torts it is always called as unliquidated damages. What do you mean by that? Nothing is prefixed, nothing is fixed. So when I say it is not fixed, what do you mean? So how much penalty, how much to pay, all that depends upon case to case. Nothing is prefixed, nothing will be fixed. Say for example everything, this will only be the penalty, that will not be there in case of torts. It is all unliquidated damages. Yes, if you remember, this is where we had stopped. Yep. So I'll tell you guys one thing. Always, always in this profession, make sure you are known. Yeah, it's okay. I mean, I'll not judge you. See, never judge the book by its cover. I totally understand. But whenever, wherever it applies to your throughout your career, yeah. So whenever you are doing something, make sure people see you. Make sure you are visible. Make sure your presence is made. This is a competent world. If you are not seen, you will be forgotten. How much ever you do, if your presence is not seen, people will not recognize your work. Now, for example, why I told others, see, when you are silent, I had to search. Now I know few people who are just there in the class. like 7 to 8 people we remember, because here and then they keep coming our names. Sir, who are they? Whenever I tell some example, those names will be coming. That is the reason I'll at least see who is ever texting or randomly I'll try to take the name also. Say for example, tomorrow I come across some opportunity. Yeah, some job opportunity, certain articleship opportunity. It is never to mention, no, whoever is that person, whoever is actively involving, that automatically goes to them, because you would have seen that person. You know what that person is. If you are in your shell, how will the other person know what is your caliber? You can be even more smart than them. But as long as you are in the well, you don't know what is going on in the ocean. So step out of your well. Yes. Life always, see, for there was a time where they said whenever an opportunity knocks your door, you need to, you know, respond it on time. Yeah. And they said, even if you do not miss this, opportunities keep knocking your door. There was certain time where they were telling that all these things were there. You know, sir, if this goes, something else will come. But today's date, guys, opportunities are gone. There is an opportunity will not come to you. If someone is still telling you that, then tell them you are outdated. If someone still tells you that opportunity keeps coming, don't worry, stay strong, stay, you know, keep fighting. Isala kapnam de no. As long as you do not create your own opportunity, the days are gone. It is a competent world. Yeah, it is a competent world. That is what happens, no? So always, everyone, it can be a slightest thing. Always make sure your presence is known. Be a unique person. I don't know if I told you this or not. See, when I was, I'm not telling you, sir, we have our own problem. We have stage fear. We have some communication issues. Sir, I don't know, sir. My doubts can be very silly. People might judge me. So what? Even the other person sitting is there also to listen only. He's also a student. Yeah, there is nothing like silly or, the best doubt. There is nothing like that. Doubt is a doubt. Never judge yourself. If you only say that your doubt is silly, then why am I sitting here? If I tell you your doubt is silly, then yes, okay, valid. If you can only tell that your doubt is silly, then why am I sitting here? Yeah, my purpose also should be served at least little. Yes, and time and again I tell you, yeah, we are not in an NGO. I get paid. You can ask me questions. Yeah, feel free. Yes, so feel free. Ask questions. Don't ask me, sir, why is Indian politics like this and all. Let us ask relevant questions. Yes. Okay, if I deviate, I'll deviate. Okay, let us come back. But why? I'm just telling you. So once you clear, sir, you said you will not deviate. Okay, this is the last story. Yeah, please. Okay. So when we finished our executive, there are certain courses we need to do. Yeah. So when we were doing, there were certain courses. Say for example, once you clear your executive and before you write your finals, there were certain workshops which will be conducted by your institute. Even now you had orientation like that. Once you clear your executive also, there will be some 10-day program, 15-day program, which you need to go and attend in the institute. So even I also went, obvious, because we have to do that to complete our course. So when I did my course on my last day, so our batch was around, I think around 22 people, 22, 28 people. Yeah. And there was one more course after professional we need to do. Yes. Which is called as MSOP. So in these two batches also, which was around 50 people will come. Minimum. All professionals to MSOP, if people are coming, that means they are all cleared CS only. That is the last ultimate step. MSOP is like, it's like your convocation ceremony. Now it is changed for you guys. So that time when I was there, when I was also a student there, there were around 40 plus students. For every student, that is a 15-day program, for every student on the last day, yeah, I had written them a letter. Yeah, not a love letter. I just written a letter for all 40 students, and there were certain coordinators and all. So for everyone, almost like 40 to 43 letters, I had written from the 7th day only. So I was writing 3 letters to 4 letters every day, and by the fag end, I completely finished it. So why? It is because whenever I feel some batch or something is special, I always communicate. I always, I also confess, I also share. Whenever I feel good, I immediately share. So I had written a letter, personalized letter for every person, that this is what is the difference you made in my life. And I felt happy for meeting you because of this reason. So for all, everyone, not copy paste, for everyone, they had their own, personalized letters, which I had written. You'll not believe me. Now all these 40 people, they are across, they're spread out in the entire India. One person is from one place. Yeah, everyone is spread out in India. Now, if they have any work in Bangalore with regards to CS or any advisory, the first person they call is me. Certain times, we had certain tie-ups. I had traveled to Kerala and all. So, either here or in Kerala, if they have any doubt, they will call me. It's not because I'll not say I was the brightest student. No. It is just because I made myself visible. I just said them this, I'm there. Yeah, I just told them that, yes, I'm here. Remember me. And this was our first day MSOP topic. Huh? So, this was our, when we cleared our CS executive, there was one course which we had to do. So, which I was doing. By then I had cleared almost all my exams. So I was doing, and few people had come even after executive also. So there was a faculty who had given us 2 minutes time. Whoever wants can go and present something. This was the first day. And the entire gang will be there for around 12 days. So we were there around say 40, 45 people. That was the strength of the batch. So they had given a topic, you can share anything. So all these people have just cleared executive. They are yet to write finals, 9 subjects. So when we have to present something, only 2 minutes was given. So I told them, guys, this is what this something one of my friend helped me with, how to present my paper. So she had given me certain inputs. So that inputs actually changed my life. So I told them, this is what I did. Yeah. So what is it? Whenever you write your paper, not relevant for you, but I'm just giving you what I shared that day. So I told them, whenever you start your paper, whenever you start your answer, start it with the provision of law. That is a subject matter. Whatever is the subject they're asking, you write that particular section there. Yes. And the second paragraph should always be analysis. The second paragraph should always be, the second paragraph should always be analysis. So first one is all the subject or provision of law. Second one should be analysis. The third one should be interpretation. Or basically conclusion, the last paragraph. This is how your answers should be in your finals. Yeah, that I'm talking about CS finals, professional level. So for now, do not worry. Do not even think of it. Yeah, and after telling all that, so we had to introduce, that was our first day. So, and then I told you, yes, by the way, I forgot introducing myself to you. I told them, whenever you're writing, this thing actually helped me a lot. It helped me to reach my goal. It helped me to clear my exams. I wish that if even this thing would change one of your lives, I'll be the most happiest person. And I did all that, and I just had 10 more seconds, and then I told, yes guys, I forgot, and by the way, my name is Sai, and that is what I wrote it here. Yes, I said this and I came back. That one day, that was our first day. I didn't tell anything else. That was not a major topic also. Back then, people in the 2 minutes, 5 minutes, few people discussed about Uri attack, why India and Pakistan are fighting, what is our economical challenges and all that. Yes, And I told them this, and this is how I showed that yes, I am there in your class. And I told them subject, yes, A, analysis, I, interpretation. And that was my name. Yes. And I literally got a, you know, the response was very good. After the entire class, that day's, you know, whoever presented the topic, they actually, you know, called me aside and they said that was a really great presentation. Someday I wish and I hope you come and present something here. So that day that faculty said that and they left. So always make sure that your presence is seen. Bala, and you told us about one teacher, if you remember. I mean, yesterday you were talking about a person. Sir, do you know her? Yeah, so I met her like this. So you ask whether do you know her. So she was one of my mentor who came there, whom I met there. So you ask her, do you know me? So I was her student. So you ask. Yes. Yes. So I don't know if this thing actually made some difference, but always make sure you're known. Now in these two batches, any day, any time, any doubt, any work. See, for us, whenever you're working, for you this networking is, that is what it matters a lot. You need to know people. Now whenever I want something to be done, I'll straight away call. I know who is where. I know people in Pune, I know people in Mumbai, I know people in Chennai, I know people in Delhi. I'll just give them a call. I'll say, this is what I wanted to be done there. Can you help me coordinate? I can get things done like this. Why? Because this is how I met them. Or else you tell me, how will you know your fellow company secretaries who are spread wide across India? What about you getting a client who is from Mumbai? Can you travel from here to there? Impossible. Networking is very, very important in your course. Yes. Okay. Now listen carefully. So we started with TOTS. Yeah. Now let us go in detail about TOTS. Yeah. So you have to keep telling this. See guys, why I tell you guys is come outside your shell. It can be anyone. Why I tell you, you have to open up. The reason I'll tell you, opportunities, not everyone, I'll not believe that, you know, as the time passed by, people will change. Yes, people might change. Until unless someone is telling that person, you have to change. Yeah, because this is how the life is. Until and unless someone doesn't tell us, we'll not come out of our shell. Yeah. Someday I'll tell you, you know, the way I was, the way I am, you know, it's totally different. So it happens. But yes, you need to work, you need to push. Now, very, very important, conditions of liability for a tort. Now, the law says very simple. Yes, whenever your legal right is affected, there was certain compensation you could get. I mean, the other person, if he does any, the trespass. If someone takes away your legal right, you can go and sue in the court of law. The court will give you what? Remedy. Remedy is what? Compensation, money. In civil wrong, always it will be, most of it will be money. Now, what are the conditions of liability for a tort? Sir, if you want to call it a tort and if you want to get compensation, what are the conditions to be met? Very simple, there are three conditions. Listen carefully, very important, yeah, ears wide open, very, very important. Let's start. Sir, when will any act, a person, now say for example, there is, whenever I told you, in a case, we will always write it as plaintiff versus defendant, correct? Plaintiff is a person who files the case. The person who writes the complaint. Defendant is a person on whom the case is filed. So plaintiff versus defendant. The plaintiff, whosoever the first name is written, that person is a person who has initiated the complaint. Defendant on whom the case is filed. Yep. Okay. Now, when will a person's act, whatever he has done, when will it become a tort? And when will you get remedy? Meaning, now what is the question? A person has done some wrong. If he has done some wrong on you, whether will you get compensation or not? So, for you to get compensation, what is that, requirements which the particular conditions which are to be fulfilled? So, first one, there must be a wrongful act. There must be a wrongful act. Act or omission of defendant. So, a defendant, that is a party against whom you are filing a case, he should have done something wrongful, which is not right, sir. That is not, I'll not appreciate it, sir. He should have done something like that. Okay. Sir, now what do you mean by this wrongful act? Wrongful act basically is so the law has given on every person certain legal rights. If a defendant is affecting the legal rights of another person, then he is committing a wrongful act. The wrongful act, when all, there are another two conditions. If you satisfy all of that, then yes, we will consider it as tort and you will get remedy. Remedy meaning you will get compensation. Now, what are those legal rights? Example. Say, for example, to live with dignity, but someone is causing some defamation. Yeah? Wrongful. No, wrong of. Your right to liberty, your freedom is taken away. Yes, someone is taking away your freedom. It can be anything. Regarding this, we will be seeing in detail. So that is the reason I've put star mark there. So we'll discuss about that later. So these are the examples. Someone is affecting your legal right. Okay, sir. So that is our first condition. Okay, sir. My legal right is affected. And what else should happen? When that legal right is affected, it may result into legal damage. So, someone has affected your legal right, meaning what, sir? Your freedom, your status. Someone has affected that, trespass, right to privacy. Someone has affected it. Because of that, you may have suffered some legal damages. What do you mean by legal damages? Some loss. That is the reason I have written here may. Why is it may? Someone has affected your legal right, but not every legal right gets converted into loss of certain legal damages. Not every legal right, whenever a legal right is affected, not every time it will get converted to a legal damage. Meaning, not every time you will suffer loss. Sir, give us an example. Trespass. When a person comes and sits inside your house, your legal right is affected, right to privacy. But have you suffered any loss? No. So, legal damages meaning suffer any loss. That is the reason I have written may. Someone may come and cause some damage also. at times, even if there is no loss, even then it will be considered as tort. There is one more condition, we'll see. So why have we written may? Not every damage is a legal damage. In the eyes of law. Only those damages which affects legal rights and which result into legal injury. So not every damage is a legal damage in the eyes of law. Only those damages which affect your legal right, which result into legal injury, only then it will be considered as a legal damage. Now what is that? For to explain this, there is a maxim. Yeah, we'll write that. There is one more thing here, third point also, so leave some space there. And I'm trying to explain you this legal damages. Yeah, after writing all three, everything will make sense. Yes, until then, yes, have patience. Now, legal damages, there are two maxims. Regarding legal damages, there are certain maxims. Sir, what do you mean by maxim? Maxim means principles. Now, what is that principle, sir? There are two maxims. To explain whatever we just wrote, there are two maxims. One is called damnum sine injuria. Damnum sine injuria. Damnum sine injuria. The other one, injuria sine damnum. Sir, you wrote something and all, we didn't understand. We'll see. Damnum sine injuria. Sir, what does that mean? Damnum means damage. Sine means without. Injuria means injury. So see, what does a law say? Very simple. We saw what is a legal right. Yes, whenever there is a legal injury, when will the legal injury be caused? See, whenever someone takes off your legal right, when someone affects your legal right, yes, that converts into a legal injury. So the law says there is a maxim called damnum sine injuria, damage without injury. The law says there are two types of maxims. What is it? At times there can be a damage. You have suffered some loss, still there is no injury. Meaning the other person did not do anything to you, but still you suffered injury. Your legal rights are not affected at all, but still you suffered damage. At that time, what will happen? That is this maxim. Listen carefully. Let us see the entire thing. If you still have a question, let us see. Yeah? Okay. Now, what do you mean by damage? Damage means It is a loss of, it can be money, it can be customers, it can be comfort. So damage means what? It is a loss. You have suffered some loss. The loss can be, you have suffered some money loss. You have lost certain money. You have lost certain customers. You have lost your comfort. All these are the losses. That is only called as legal damages. So damage without injury. So you have suffered some loss without any injury. Sir, now what do you mean by this? So without is very well known. Injury means, injury of a legal right of another. So when does it result into an injury? It results into an injury when you cause a damage. If your injury of a legal right of another, if another person's legal right is taken off, there is an injury. Okay, sir, now actually explain us what this maxim say. Listen carefully. There is a very interesting case law. Listen carefully. What do you mean by damage without injury? Loss is, you have suffered some loss without your legal rights getting affected. And under such circumstances, what will happen? Listen carefully. There was one academy. Yeah, there was a tuition. In this tuition, there was a person. Yeah, so this was a tuition, or say this was a college or anything. There was a person who was a teacher here. Yeah, so this teacher was associated with tuition for almost around 4 to 5 years. In this 4 to 5 years, this teacher had a very goodwill. I mean, he was very known in the students. Now what happened? After say some 4 to 5 years, the teacher and this tuition, they fought. The management and the teacher, they fought. And what happened? The teacher moved away from the tuition. And he formed his own tuition. Where? In the same street. This tuition was XYZ. He formed a new tuition called ABC. Yes, so there was a teacher who fought with them, and he moved away from that tuition and he formed his own tuition where in the same place. Now both of them are in the same road. Now this teacher was pretty wanted. People liked him, so he also gave certain quality teaching. So what happened? The teacher, as and when he formed the tuition, all the students came and joined ABC tuition. Yeah, all the students came to ABC tuition and they joined the new teacher's tuition itself. Whoever was a teacher here, the same teacher, they joined that particular tuition. This tuition was XYZ was doing really good in the past. Now after this, what happened? XYZ started losing all its students. Eventually, people started leaving their tuition and they started going to ABC. So what happened? XYZ had a huge damage. He suffered a huge damage. What damage? His profits started coming down. There was a loss of what? Loss of money. How? His profits started coming down. Okay, sir, then he started losing his customers. When I say customers here, his students, they left them and they went to ABC. Now, what did this XYZ person do? XYZ person went and he filed a case in the court. What did he file? He said, "Your Honor, this person has caused a lot of damage to me." "Your Honor, he has caused money loss. He has caused, you know, whatever loss possible. He has done that to me." He went to the court. Court said, "Oh, that is, man, that is what we were looking for. Come, have a seat. Let us discuss your case." Now in the court, court asked, "What did he do?" "Sir, he caused a huge damage to me." "Oh, is it? What did he do? Did he tell anything negative about you?" "No, sir. He did not tell anything negative about me." "Okay. Did he come and hit you?" "No, sir. He did not come and hit me." "Did he come and threaten you?" "No, sir. He didn't do anything like that." "Did he give you any false negative publicity?" "No, sir." "Did he come and lock your shutter, your tuition doors?" "No, sir. He didn't do anything like that." "Did he give you a warning?" "No, sir." "Did he give a warning to his customers?" "No, sir. He didn't do that." "Then what did he do?" "Sir, he caused a huge loss to me, sir." Now court asked, "How? What happened then?" "Sir, this person opened a new tuition in front of me. All the customers, they went to his tuition. Leaving my particular tuition, all the my students, they left my tuition and they went and joined this new tuition, sir." "Oh, is it? Okay. Because of which, people coming to my tuition started reducing. My profit started reducing. My customers left me. And finally, I suffered a huge loss. I suffered a very big legal damage, sir. There was a huge damage for me. Damage of money, loss, everything." Now the court said, "Now whatever he did not do anything illegal. See, did he take out your right to privacy? No. Did he take out your liberty? No. Did he cause any damage to your status? No. Did he cause any bodily harm? Did he hit you? No. Then he did not injure you at all. Your legal rights he did not affect at all. He caused a damage to you, agreed. But did he take away any of your legal right? No, sir. He's a very good man. He did not touch me at all. He grew only because of whatever he had. He did not damage me, sir. He did not touch me at all." So the court said, "See, your legal rights are protected. They did not have it. It was not at all, nothing happened. None of them touched your legal rights." "Yes, sir. None of them touched my legal rights." "Now, what do you want?" "Sir, I want compensation." "Why?" "Sir, I have suffered damages, no? So what do you want?" "I want remedy." "What remedy?" "I want money compensation. Whatever loss I have suffered, tell him to bear the loss. Tell him to give me all that money." The last third point here was legal remedy. Legal remedy meaning compensation. Something written. Okay, sir. Okay, now what happened? The court said, "Hey, you are doing all nonsense natak. Get out of my motherland." "Why, sir?" That maxim itself is called as damage without injury. See, one person has suffered a loss. Yeah, you have suffered a loss, but is your legal rights affected? No, sir. So remember, even if you have suffered any damages, even if you have suffered any loss, if at all, no one has affected your legal right. None of them has done an injury to your legal right. As long as your legal rights are not affected, even though if you have suffered any loss, then law says no remedy. Yes, so what do you mean by damnum sine injuria? There are damages. You have suffered loss. without a legal injury. What do you mean by legal injury? Without your legal rights getting affected. Now, whatever case I told you is popularly called as Gloucester Grammar School case. Now, whatever case we just discussed, that particular case is known as Gloucester Grammar School case. It's okay, Rachana, it takes time. See, even in Contract Act also, if you don't remember example also, it's fine. But if you know the concept from your MCQ perspective, that is sufficient. Because MCQ, you need to know the concept. Because you are not writing, right? So it's okay. It is multiple choice, so it's okay. Yeah, but whenever I write a case law, try to remember that case law name. Yes. But did you guys understand this? Yes. I'll tell you. Once we complete the entire scenario, I'll tell you if there is any other. I will share. Yeah? Okay. Sir, so what does it say? See, if at all there should be a tort, then your legal right should be affected. Even if you have suffered a loss or not, that is not it what is matters. You will get a legal remedy. Yeah? After writing all that, I will write a final table. Then you will get to know. Let us go to the next part. What is it? Injuria sine damnum. Now, what do you mean by this? There is an injury. Sine means what? Without. Damnum, damages. Same thing, whatever we wrote there. So now what does the law say? Someone has taken away your legal right. Someone has taken away a legal right given to you by the law. Legal right is taken away. Okay, sir, your legal right is taken away. Did you suffer any loss? No, sir, I did not suffer any loss. Give me an example. Right to privacy. Whenever, for example, whenever you are in your home, some random stranger comes and he sits on your sofa and watches the IPL match with you. What is that? Your legal right of freedom, privacy. That is being affected. Someone is coming and encroaching your legal right. That is your right to privacy. So, okay, the court asked, have you suffered any damage? No, sir, this person did not do any damage in my house. Now, will you get any remedy? Will you get any compensation? That is the second maxim, injuria sine damnum. Okay, now. Okay, how many of you have watched the movie? Sarkar, Tamil. How many of you have watched? Vijay's movie. Yeah, you have watched. Oh man, many of the. Oh my God, all of you. Okay, listen. Now, what exactly happens in this movie? I'll just tell you a short story. What happens in this movie? Vijay, a very famous business person who will be in US or somewhere. In India, there will be elections going on. Yeah? So, Vijay, from US to India, he travels. He comes to India. Why? Just to cast his vote. He wants to vote in the election. Yeah? So he has a very, what do you say? As a responsible citizen, he comes from there to India just to cast his vote. So when he comes, what happens in India? You know, this happens, you know, used to happen at times, even it happens now. There is something called as bid rigging. Yeah? Fake votes. What do you mean by that? There will be already a quite a number of people who will not. See, they are entitled to come and vote, but they won't vote. So what these politicians do, there are a few people, what they do, instead of them, in their name, they will send some dummy people. So for example, assume there is Shashikant. Shashikant, his name is there on that electoral poll. He has to come and vote, but he is not coming. So I will go and I will cast vote on his behalf. This is called, in a way, casting the fake votes. Yeah, manipulating the votes. So what happens in this movie, Vijay would have come from US to India just to cast a vote, just to put his vote. Yeah, he's a very famous business person. When he's inside the polling booth, when he's about to cast his vote, the officer tells him, no, you cannot cast your vote. Vijay asks, why? I am a legal citizen. I am over 18. I have my voter ID. Why can't I cast my vote? The person whoever is in voting bull, the poll bull, he says that, sorry sir, your vote has already been cast. Someone has already put your vote. Yes, the entire movie starts from there. It's a nice commercial movie. If not, watch. Sir, now why did you tell this here? Let us come back to our case law. Yeah, that this movie is somehow related to your case law. Yeah, this is a very old case law. Now listen carefully. There was a person called Mr. A. Yeah? So same thing. Mr. A wants to go and he wanted to vote. There will be a person called Mr. B. Mr. B is the officer. You know, who will be sitting in that polling booth. So when A goes to cast his vote, B says, no, I won't let you to cast your vote. Same thing, the movie, same thing if you remember. Vijay will go to court and all to fight for this one vote. Because of his one vote, the entire re-elections will happen. If you remember, I don't know if you guys have seen that movie or not. Yeah. So in this also same thing happens. What? This person won't be able to cast his vote. Mr. B will not allow him to cast his vote. Now what happens? Mr. A gets angry. A goes and files a case in the court. A goes and files a case in the court saying, sir, right to vote is my legal right. Right to vote in my country is a legal right. If I am 18 plus, I have my voter ID and all other conditions are being satisfied. I have a right to vote. I have all those things. But this person did not allow me to vote. You should only protect my interest. Now, court asked, okay. Tell me, which party do you wanted to vote for? He said, sir, the election was between BJP and Congress. I wanted to vote for BJP. Oh, is it? Yes, sir. I wanted to vote for BJP. Now, who won the elections? Yes, by the way, by the time all this went to court, all this happened, the election, the results were also declared. Yes, so BJP only won the election. Now the court asked, see, you wanted to vote for BJP, correct? Yes, sir, I wanted to vote for BJP. Now, you wanted to vote for BJP, BJP only won. What difference did it make in your life? You wanted to vote for BJP, yes. Even without your vote, BJP only won the case. You did not suffer any loss at all. Are you getting my point? I wanted to vote for BJP. BJP only won the election. Did you suffer any loss? He said, no, sir. I did not suffer any loss. Did you lose money? No. Did you lose your job? No. Did whatever party you wanted to vote for, did they not win the election? They won with majority, sir. Then what? What did you lose? Sir, I did not lose anything. But my legal right to vote was affected. Now, the court said, yes, that is point. His legal right is taken away. His right to vote is a legal right given by the country itself to the entire citizens of India. How can someone take away that from you? Yes. So, in this case, there was a legal injury. What do you mean by legal injury? His legal right was affected. Did you suffer any loss? Did you suffer any legal damages? The answer is no. Still, the court says, still you are entitled for legal remedy. Meaning what? See, whatever the individual's right, whatever are the legal rights given to you, that no one can take it away from you. So, even though you have not suffered any loss, still the law says you are entitled for compensation. So the compensation we'll talk. Remedy is your last topic of your chapter. What in all will be the compensation? What will be the legal remedy? Yes. So what are the two maxims? In short, there are three elements. What is it? The first one is legal injury. Legal injury of what? Legal injury of your legal right. So now write down our short table. What does it say? So first question, is your legal right affected? Yes, sir. Have you suffered any damages, loss? Yes, sir. You will get legal remedy. Meaning compensation. You can write here loss. Here compensation. Sir, have you suffered any legal right? Yes, sir. Someone has injured my legal right. Did you suffer any loss? No, sir. But still, you will enjoy compensation. Yes? Huh. And one more thing. Whatever this example we saw, that BJP versus Congress, Sarkar movie, in reality, this example is nothing but Ashby versus White. This is the case law in reality. Ashby versus White. So when Ashby went to vote, White did not give him the right to vote. Yes, this is the case law. Ashby versus White. Remember. Yes, Ashby versus White. Okay, sir. Now, have you suffered any legal right? No, sir. But have you suffered any loss? Yes, sir. Will you get any remedy? Answer is no. This obvious. So this in short is your table. Any doubt in the entire thing? So the second maxim is where all your trespass, yeah, all that comes and sits in there only. Someone has kidnapped you. I mean, someone has detained you somewhere. They did not allow you to step outside. Your personal freedom. No, there was no harm. Yes, you can take it in that way also. Yes. Possible. Denial of passport. Yes. Injury without damage. So whenever the law has given you a legal right, then if someone denies you, yes, it results into legal remedy. Are you getting the point? All of you. So under torts, if there should be a liability, these three conditions should be satisfied. All of you. Whoever is there in the class, any doubt, important, whatever we discussed, important. Yes, you can even take that also. But as long as there is no other law made, if there is any specific law made, then it will be dealt as per that particular law. If you remember, that is what we saw in Friday's class. All of you understood? So that was injuria sine damnum, damnum sine injuria. Yeah, damages without injury, injury without damages. Okay, sir. Now, there is one more concept which is there in criminal law. Yeah. Now, what is that? Listen carefully. There is something called as mens rea. Sir, what is this mens rea? Yeah, there's one more topic called as mens rea, which is very predominant in criminal law. Listen carefully. I'll tell you a story. Yeah, you tell me whether whatever it is right or wrong. You should not ask further questions. Yeah, you should just say right or wrong. Punishable, not punishable. That's all. You should not ask further questions. Yeah, remember the condition. There was a person. Yeah, she killed another person. So there was a girl, Miss A. She killed a person called Mr. A. She killed brutally. Yeah, she killed. Now tell me whether what she did, is it right or wrong? Is it an offense or not? She should be punishable or wrong? She should be punishable or not? Punishable? Hey Rakesh. Hey. Rakesh Godiro. She is asking, sir, what was the reason? Just now I asked you, hey. You. Now you got the... I know, man, you will ask that. That is the reason I clearly told you. You should not ask me why. Yeah? Okay. So, all of a sudden, it is punishable. Now, there is second question to you. This person tried an attempt to rape. Now, this was the reason. Now, tell me. Punishable, not punishable. Why? What changed? What changed? What changed? Whatever she did, she still killed him. What changed? What made you guys change your decision? Why? Why? Okay, self-defense. Okay. In order to protect herself, she killed it. So did you mean that, sir, she did not have intention to kill him, but to protect herself, she had to kill him? That is what you are telling? Yes. Exactly, sir. That exactly is called as mens rea. Sir, what do you mean by mens rea? Mens rea means guilty mind. What do you mean by that? Always remember, in criminal law, mens rea is very important. What do you mean by that? If you have to punish any person, now for example, in our case, if you have to punish that girl, the law, the court has to prove mens rea. You have to prove that, yes, what the girl did was wrong. If you cannot prove that, you cannot punish the girl. That concept itself is called as mens rea. Meaning what? If a person is not guilty, if a person has not done that act with a guilty mind, with a wrong mind, with a wrong intention, if that is not there, then you cannot punish that person at all. Courts cannot punish it. Courts cannot punish her. Now, the way you changed your decision, the same way even they will change. That is what every court will look for. How many of you have heard that? Even if 99 convicts get out, if they walk out free from the court, at least one innocent should not be punished. Have you heard of that? It is okay even if 99 convicts, you know, the actual people get out of the court, that is totally fine. but one person, an innocent person, should not be punished. That is what is called mens rea. When I say innocent, here yes, she killed, but why? How? That you need to check. That is called as guilty mind. Now, so there is a maxim which says, actus reus non facit, actus reus non facit, reum nisi mensit rea. Actus reus non facit, reum nisi mensit rea. Sir, pakka sir. If you tell all this, we will walk out, sir. What is this, sir? Let us write in English. Act itself creates no guilt. In the absence of guilty mind. So it sounds like little Arab. Actus reus non facit, reum nisi mensit rea. Wingardium leviosa. Yeah, that is how it sounds. Yes. So, yes, sir. Now, what exactly is this? Mens rea. Now, why are we talking about this? Yeah, sir, we discussed that tort is a civil wrong. Why is criminal coming into picture? Why? There is a relevance. What is it? Whatever this guilty mind concept is there, this in criminal law, in civil law. So, not punishable without mental fault. Yes. Actus reus non facit, reum nisi mensit rea. Actus reus non facit, reum nisi mensit rea. Yes. So, in criminal law, as long as a person has done anything with guilty mind, you cannot punish the person otherwise. If he has done it with guilty mind, only then you can punish. Sir, how about civil law? In civil law, mens rea is not applicable. It takes a little time, but you will be there. Eventually, you will be there. Yeah. All things are like that only. Yeah. So, how I used to prepare, I used to write down all the maxims in one page. What is a maxim? What is the meaning? Ubi jis ibi remedium. All the same thing. Where there is a right, there is a remedy. You have to just remember everything. You know, write down in one place, constantly, continuously, sometime or other, you have to keep looking at it. Yes? So, what does it say? This guilty mind concept is not applicable in civil law. So, if a person has done wrong only, why? Sir, why is it so important? Now, listen. Now, say for example, if a person has done some civil wrong, now what is civil wrong? We know the breach of contract, defamation. Now you tell me, sir, I did not have intention, sir. Sir, I was poor, sir. See, just because you are poor, you went and you snatched the chain from someone else's neck. So whatever you did does not make your act good. Correct? So under civil law, mens rea is not seen. Under criminal law, mens rea is relevant. Yes? So that is what I wanted to say. That is the reason we took mens rea. Understood this mens rea concept, everyone? Any doubts? See, when you have no doubts, no, there are two interpretations. One, you have understood everything. Two, you have not understood anything. Sir, if we understand only, no, sir, doubts. No, we didn't understand only. No doubts. Simple. Ha, correct. Yes. Personal right, personal liberty, right to live with dignity, all those things come there. Yes. Ha, okay. Now, guys, remember those two cases of Gloucester Grammar School case. Damnum sine injuria. Injuria sine damnum, Ashby versus White, the Oat case. Yeah, one that tuition case and the other one is Oat case. Remember, both are important. Yeah? Sir, it is like movie only, we are enjoying the story. No, remember. Enjoy the story, but remember. Kinds of tortious liability. Guys, open a fresh page, do a landscape. Too much to write. Strict liability or strict liability or absolute liability. The second one, vicarious liability or vicarious liability, whatever they say, one and the same. Vicarious liability, vicarious liability, both are pronunciations. Yeah, very, very important. Again, case laws, listen, very interesting topic. What do you mean by tortious liability? Sir, tort, yes, tort. Under tort, there is something called as kind of tortious liability. There are two types of thing which can happen. If you do a mistake, if you knowingly do a mistake, then absolutely no problem. Mens rea not applicable. So you are punishable. Sir, what if I don't even know that I did a mistake? Then that is the reason this concept came into picture. Strict and absolute liability. Now what is that? See, it's a very interesting one. Very, very interesting one. Generally, people tell strict and absolute liability are almost one and the same. Yeah, they say it is almost one and the same. However, there is a little difference. I'll tell you how. Now, first let us see what is strict liability. This was first held in a very important case law called Riland versus Fletcher, or also called as Ryland versus Fletcher. Riland versus Fletcher or Ryland versus Fletcher. Sir, now what is this key? What is this case? Okay, come back. Let us story mode. Come on, story mode. What is that case? Now listen carefully. There were two people. Yeah, they were living in a town, very happily living. Yeah, one person's name was called as Riland, Mr. Riland. The other person's name is called as, I think, Okay. Listen, one person's name was called as Reliant, the other person's name was called as Fletcher. Now, this Reliant was doing mill business. Yeah, he was into mill. He wanted supply of lot of water. He wanted supply of lot of water. So what did he do? He thought, see, I want lot of water. I cannot arrange it. Every now and then I cannot go. I cannot keep getting water tanks and all that is practically does not work out. So what did this person do? He thought of constructing his own reservoir. A small pond. Yeah, he thought of constructing his own reservoir, water reservoir. So, for which he hired one independent contractor. Meaning what? He hired a person, he said, see, I want a pond, yeah, an artificial reservoir, like a dam. Why? Because I want it for my business purpose. For my mill, I wanted lot of supply of water. So, kindly construct a reservoir for me, for which I will pay you. Independent contractor said, okay, I will do that. Absolutely no problem. Yes, you can consider like that. Yes. Yeah, but not... Yes, in a way, yes. I'll tell you why. There is a little thing. Yes, a little of principal agent thing is there, but I'll tell you how. Now listen carefully. Mr. R, he gave the money and he told the independent contractor to construct this reservoir. When this independent contractor was constructing this reservoir, there were certain shafts in this ground. Sir, what do you mean by shaft? Shaft means opening. Two places it will be opening. There was an opening here. Yeah, imagine there were pipes, some old pipes. Yes. So when he was constructing, he did not look at the shafts properly. He thought something is there and he just took some mud. He did not even cover it with cement. He did not even cover it with some, granite or nothing. He just covered it with some loose mud. So whatever those pipes were, he just covered all that pipes with some loose mud. So it was totally covered with mud. Whatever were that openings, he just covered that opening with some loose mud. And the reservoir was completed. Now Mr. R started filling water in that reservoir. Yeah? When he was filling water, this pipes, whatever were here, he did not cover that pipes properly with cement. So what happened? There was one hidden story in this. What? These pipes were connected down the line. It was like a hill. Here, there was one more person called Fletcher. Fletcher had a coal mine here. Yeah, he had coal mine. He was doing the business of coal mine. So this was like this hill. So these pipes, they did not know that these pipes came out of this Fletcher's land. They were connected. The moment the water was filled into this reservoir, these pipe, mud was there, it was loosened and the water poured out into the coal mine of Fletcher. The water poured out here, his entire coal mine was flooded with water. He suffered a huge loss. Huge loss was suffered by Fletcher. Why? Because he lost all entire stock, whatever he had of that coal. Now, what did Fletcher do? Fletcher went and filed a case in the court on Reliant. He said, Your Honor, because of this person, I lost my entire coal field. I suffered a huge loss. You kindly tell him to repay the money for all the loss I have suffered. Reliant said, Your Honor, I seriously beg you, I did not know that this thing was there. Please kindly forgive me. I did not know. I didn't do it wantedly. I didn't even know that these pipes were connected. It was not my fault. Second thing, I did not construct this reservoir. I hired one independent contractor. He constructed. Why should I pay the penalty? Please forgive me. I did not do it. Kindly have some, what do you say, mercy on me, please. So for those of you who did not understand the figure, so I have given you a graph also here, yeah, the picture. So this was a reservoir. So water reservoir. So there were certain connected pipes. So it broke out into the Fletcher's coal mine here. Yeah. So here it was Reliance mill. Here it was Fletcher's mill. Yeah. I hope you got the case. All of you understood or not? Yes. Huh. See, Mensriya. Now say, Mensriya. Why is it not there in civil law? Are you getting the point? In this case, the court said the first time there was one maxim, one principle which was passed. That principle is called as Reland versus Fletcher's principle, or also called as the principle of strict liability. Now, what do you mean by strict liability? Listen carefully. It is even helpful for you from your regular scenario also. In your day-to-day life also, this principle is helpful. Is it, sir? Why? Replace the entire thing, instead of water, replace it with dog. If Reland had a dog, if that dog went and bit the Fletcher, yeah? Now, is Reland responsible? Is Reland liable for that? He did not, his intention is not to harm Fletcher. But yes, the dog went and bit Fletcher. Now, should Reland pay the loss for it? Should he suffer the damage? That is what is coming under strict liability. Now, see what does it say. Write down. If a person brings something likely to do mischief, mischief meaning harm. If a person brings anything which is likely to do harm, okay, so if a person is bringing something which is likely to do harm, and if such thing, if such thing escapes, in such case, he must keep it at his own peril. What do you mean by peril? Peril means risk. And it should be a non-natural use of land. Now, what does this particular judgment says? See, if a person is bringing and keeping something which, if at all it escapes, it will do mischief, then you have to keep such thing at your own risk. Now, read it with replacing it with dog. If you bring a dog and if you keep it with you, if at all that dog escapes, if it is going to do mischief, if it escapes, it will cause a harm, then you have to keep such thing at your own risk. Meaning what? If such thing happen, then strict liability will come into picture. You have to pay compensation. Even if an independent contractor has also built it, the liability is not on the independent contractor. Why? Because he just helped you. But tomorrow, such big amount of water, anything can happen tomorrow. If something happens and that water comes out, you have to keep it in your risk only. No matter who has done it. Even independent contractor does it, you are responsible. Why? Because you are keeping such a thing which is very risky to keep. Imagine a dam of water, a reservoir of water. That is the reason they added the fourth point. What difference does it make? If I have a cute little Rottweiler, the end of the day dog only, no? What if it's cute? You are liable, obviously. That is what a strict liability. Yeah? Now, listen carefully. The fourth point says, such use should be a non-natural use of land. See, Ryland can say, sir, it is my land. I did it in my land. It is my choice. I can do anything in my land. Why should I be responsible to him? See, people would say that. But if you are making a non-natural use of land, see, natural use, you can have a, what do you say, a bucket of water, you know, you can have a tree, you know, you can have a normal fence. But say, for example, in a normal person's site, yeah, you're living in a residential place, you're having a windmill in front of your house. Yeah, it is a non-natural use of land. Tomorrow, if that windmill falls, it is on you. So in your land, you're constructing a dam. Now imagine you're in a Kormangla. Yeah, you're in Kormangla. Imagine someone constructs a dam here in Kormangla. I mean, I'm talking about, say, you're in Bangalore. Imagine someone is constructing a, you know, dam here. Are you getting the point? In whatever it is available, they will construct. Then, so such use by any person should be a non-natural use of land. Natural means how every normal person will use it. Non-natural, something unique. If you use it, you are strictly liable. Strictly liable, meaning what? No exception at all. I'll not listen to your story. Whatever is the loss, pay him the damage. All conditions are to be satisfied. Okay. Let's do one thing. Let's go for a break and come, and then let us resume. Yes?